this is the team that preseason looks like it's the one to beat. So I should get clobbered. It's also a decent test for some updates on the recording equipment. Every time you update something, something else changes. And when you don't know what you're doing, things get a little hairy sometimes. Yeah, so this, there's about three or four more teams that had enough of a roster to be able to play against them as in their pre-draft format. So happens that one of the best teams in the league is one of them. See how these guys compare to Houston. I'm sure they'll probably be better. Start off against the Cy Young winner, who's not Jam. How's that? It's a 35 though. Oh shit, I haven't seen 35 in ages. How is Sandy Alcantara not a Jam pitcher? It doesn't make any sense to me. Interesting. When you see this lineup, yeah, Jose Ramirez hitting seventh. All right. Maybe it's just his lefty configuration. Maybe I shouldn't look. Thank you. I'm going to hate his defense all year long. I don't have anybody that isn't a D at first. I don't have anybody that isn't a D at short. Quite a few single numbers on that card. Almost 100 by my count. Yeah, there's almost 50 in the bottom. Yeah. There's 100 numbers on that card. On the right side, anyway. Cy Youngs and MVPs. Even runs well. Good defense. Wow. Decent defense. Same with Turner. He's a great player. Will Smith's probably the best catcher in baseball. That's a great team. Oh, if I get any bad luck at all, I'm done. Yep. That's a surprisingly small home run range for B power. 14 numbers. I've got C power on the right side with more numbers than that. There's 20, 21 for C power. There's It's weird how it works. I'm not sure what the formula is. I know how they come up with the formula for A power, C power, and B power, and all that stuff, but I know how they actually get the home run numbers on the cards. Because it seems a little off every year. Not a criticism, just an observation. There always seems to be a few guys who get... only a B. Didn't miss a start. out for a week. Harlan Garcia. All right, well, that instantly makes my cards reasonable. Well, that's it for me. Staying put on 8? Must be because there's nobody out. Sacrificial offering of Brad Keller. Yeah, he's getting out of hand now. Any bad luck whatsoever against a team this good, you're bound to just get pummeled. I wonder if, because I was playing against a righty, the lefty comes in, I wonder if it counts against the limited at-bats. Okay, 2 at-bats. See what happens when I get down to the bottom. Probably walk. There'd be no answer for that question. Solid defense all the way around too, other than same spots that I'm weak at. Defensively anyway. I mean, I'm weak at a lot of spots, but only weak in a couple spots defensively. See if JD can get us on the board. With his patented doubles. Gonna be my biggest offensive weapon this year, the hit by pitch. Okay, find out right here. Walk. Nope, sacrifice fly. Son of a bitch. Oh, it's two out. Okay, good. See if that went down to one. Let's have a look, shall we? It did. Okay, so it does count. All right. Taking our pen and paper. Face-to-face Dice League, we wouldn't count those, but yeah, sometimes it's hard to know what the computer game is gonna do. They give you the rules, but you don't know exactly how it's gonna interact, going all the way back to the one game playoff way back in, I guess, 2021, after the 2020 season. We didn't know if it was going to reset for the playoffs, if it was going to treat it like a playoff game, treat it like a regular season game. Probably should have been something I was more observant with in the past, but really, it doesn't come up much. Don't usually use limited players very often. This would just make the game infinitely longer. But play it like I would play it during the regular season. Might as well have them try and steal. There's not much downside to that. Other than it was his pick. If I got a couple rolls, I'd be right back in this game, but. Nope. Remember to pinch hit for Langoliers. Gotta get Robert and Kepler out of there too. Let him have his lefty at bat though. Trying to get his batting average up to 100. Replace him with another 100 hitter. That's a big range. 67 numbers, 68 numbers. What a beast. And a good dude, too. It's nice to see guys who aren't jerks do well. Bad Brad might have a couple more in him there. What's he on? 2.1? Yeah. Visibility is excellent at Fenway. Mark you down for a hit. Oh, cue the rally. Well, this will be game 9 of this playthrough. Lowe's struggled. He gets hot for little stretches, though. I guess the same in real baseball. Had a good game. He's not a bad player. Seen him play a fair bit. I don't think he'll ever become a superstar, but you could definitely do worse. Best closer in baseball? Well, him or Diaz. Stuff-wise, anyway. Haven't seen his card. Imagine it's pretty spectacular. Yeah. He's always go over Pache's head. Yep. Just jinxed myself. The reverse jinx. Speaking of which, when Robert inevitably gets hurt because he's a D, we haven't used Pache a lot. Who wants the ninth? I think AJ Puck does. He's got a lot of innings left. Our young Andrew Miller clone. You're out. Not young anymore. I think he's 26, 27. Time of the card beam is 28, so I mean he'll be 29 pretty soon. Before long he'll be 30. Although I think it took Andrew Miller almost that long to become decent, and he was good for 4 years, I want to say. Real good. I'm kind of hoping for the same thing from Puck. Should have a pretty good bullpen. Hopefully one of them establishes themselves as a closer. Best stuff is probably Gratterall, but he doesn't strike guys out very often. The wise guys got good stuff too. Oh, they all have good stuff. Talking closer lights out. Class A kind of stuff. Play one more game with a righty pitcher. See what his righty lineup is like, and then I'll shut it down for the day. Save the last two beatings for another day. I think Aaron Judge is going to make an error to extend this game. Give the mob a chance. I didn't think so. All right, let's go to the box score. Wonder if the box score shows up on the new. It does, look at that. I'll be a son of a bitch. It's almost like I know what I'm doing. Clearly I don't. .364, .333. These guys at the bottom, but everybody else is struggling. My whole team is struggling. Except for JD. And the Langoliers. Scuba pitched okay. That error by Magical did him dirty a little bit. That was a bad break.